Thank you for being on The Tonight Show. I appreciate this.
It's pretty crazy. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, good, yeah. Now, can you just, I know, please just walk me through what happened. I know you probably told the story now 1,000 times.
But... I could tell it to you all day, man.
Yeah. It's August 21st. What time of the day is it now?
It's about 5 p.m. or so.
Okay.
We're just in the middle of our Europe trip on our way to Paris. We were just coming from Amsterdam with my friends.
Okay.
And I was actually asleep at the time, and a gunshot and glass starts breaking. And then I don't really notice because I'm asleep. And then a train employee kind of sprints by us down the hallway, and that commotion kind of wakes me up. And then I look over at my friends, and they're looking back, and they duck down. So I'm like, what are they looking at? And then I look back, and there's the gunman just coming in the train, cocking an AK. And I was like, is this real? Like, somebody playing a joke?
Yeah.
And then the next second, I look over back at my friends, and then he's just like, go. And then both of them get up, so then I just followed them. I was like, I guess this is real.
So they jumped up and they just attacked him and got the gun out of his hand?
Yeah, we kind of, he said go. My friend Spencer got up, ran. My friend Alec got up and ran. So then I got up after I saw them go. And then I fully expected a gunshot to go off before we got there, but it just never did, thank God. And then Spencer hopped on him. A few seconds later, me and Alec were there, and then we got to beat him down a little bit.
Yeah. Got to beat him down a little bit. I mean, this guy, they found magazines like, and he had a bag full of stuff, but also he pulled out a knife as you guys are wrestling the guy.
Yeah.
A box cutter.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. He, in the midst of us beating him up, he dropped the gun. So then he pulled out a box cutter, and my friend Spencer had him in a chokehold, so he tried to, like, cut him a little bit. So then we had to beat him up a little more, and then he dropped that. Then once he dropped that, we knocked him until he was unconscious, and then Chris came out and helped us tie him up.
So you tied him up. Now, how do you know how to tie someone up?
That was completely Chris's idea. We were screaming for some help. We pinned him on the ground, and then Chris came up, and it was actually his idea to hog tie him, so that's how he ended up tied up like that.
And it was your iPhone video that we all saw, all the footage.
Like... Yeah, right. After we turned around and seen Mr. Mulligan bleeding from the neck, so I was rushing around trying to find how we could stop him from bleeding, because that's the first time I seen him. I didn't know how he had gotten injured like that. And then my friend Spencer, he has some medical training in the Air Force, so he came over and stuck his two fingers in his neck until the paramedics came.
Is that unbelievable?
Yeah,
it's gosh.
Quick thinking on his part.
But you have no military training?
No, just a student, yeah.
You're just a student in Sacramento?
Yeah, in Sacramento, California.
Yeah, and so you just hang with your buddies who have military training, and that's good guys to hang out with.
Yeah.
Yeah, I tell you. Turns out it's pretty fun.
Now, I couldn't have picked a better two to be with, that's
yeah.
for sure.
And you almost didn't make this train, right? Or you weren't
right.
going to be on this
We were having so much fun in Amsterdam, we actually almost stayed. Well.
All right, now we're done. Oh, yeah. So.
Yeah.
You're in Esther because it's so pretty there.
Because it's beautiful.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. You're taking photographs and, taking the art scene.
Museums left and
oh,
right.
Oh, yeah, Van Gogh.
So
oh,
my gosh. We have a great time out there.
Yeah, of course. That's what people do in Amsterdam. Yeah, so you wanted to stay a little extra. So you were sleeping on the train. Yeah, okay, yeah.
Right.
Oh, it makes sense. It's all putting it all. Hey, yeah, I'm what the... So you get off, and the first thing, what all this going through, it probably happened 2 seconds in your mind. How long was the thing? Do you know? Do you have any time?
I kind of played it back, and it was probably the whole ordeal probably only lasted about a minute to 2 minutes. We put it on him pretty fast.
Wow. Yeah. And then the train pulls off to the first stop they could possibly.
Yeah, it took about 20 minutes for us to pull into the station. Luckily, Spencer had his two fingers in. Mark's neck the whole time.
Now, Mark is the guy who got shot with the first bullet in the glass, is what you heard.
I guess that's eventually what happened. We didn't see that, but I guess that's where he received that injury. And then Spencer just, he saved his life because he was about to die. He saved his life, really.
No one died?
No, no one.
Unbelievable what you did. That is such a great story. And the first person you called, your dad?
I called him. It's kind of funny because I was thinking, like, how do I even describe what just happened?
Like, Dad, sit down. Yeah.
I called him, and then I was like, well, first off, like, I'm okay. Like, yeah, I'm fine. I was like, but a terrorist was on our train and he actually tried to shoot everybody, and me, Spencer, and Alec had to jump him. And he was like, okay. And then, and then I was like,
he's like, how was Amsterdam, son? Yeah. Are you still there? Yeah, okay. Yeah.
And then it was like kind of chaotic. So I told him, I'll call him back when I can, but I have to go right now. And he was like, okay, just call me when you can. And that was that, really.
Well, he's got to be so proud of you. Dad is here in the audience tonight. Where is your dad? There he is, right there. Hey, Dad. You got to be proud of this guy, right? Oh, my God. I mean, wow. Not only is your dad proud and Sacramento proud, but the United States is proud, and every country is proud. Thank you, and you're a good man, please. Oh, my God, thank you so much. Thank you for coming on the show. He has Anthony Sandler, everyone.